Apparently, college professors, university professors are freaking out and think that the college essay is dead. This is a headline of a recent article in The Atlantic. There's a new AI that I think is called ChatGPT, I haven't used it, that can apparently write essays on just about any topic. So you can ask it, you know, what does Heidegger mean with being towards death, and it produces an acceptable essay that would probably get in America some sort of a B minus, maybe a B plus, somewhere along the bell curve. You see, somewhere in England it would probably be somewhere around a 65, which is a what they also call a 2-1 or a 2-2, so just about average. Now here's something that's striking though, and people have suggested we should reintroduce handwritten essays. That's a good idea. But the reason why professors are really freaking out and TAs is because here's the machine, AI, that is breaking the already completely machinic operation that is essay writing and essay marking. I have marked hundreds, if not thousands, of essays myself at different universities in the UK. And I tell you one thing, how often I was told to remark every single essay because I didn't use the words and the terms that we are supposed to use when you mark, because you have these marking criteria and you have to use the buzzwords in the bracket for a certain mark, or else the student will get confused. That's already purely machinic. And guess what? Essays will do well that are written as if they were written by a machine anyways. Essays that dare to think, essays that dare to go a bit weird and crazy, they're crowded out. They're usually not a fail, but they're a very low mark usually. So you see, I think it's very hilarious that the college essay is not dead now, it has been dead for decades. And it is now the machine, the new AI system, that actually brings this finally, it's an apocalyptic moment really, it brings to the fore that it has been dead for a long time, and that it is, it comes down to how we understand or have come to understand university education, writing and marking those essays also. So again, it is striking that it is the operations of the machine, it is the advent, let's say, of AI that shows us how machinic everything had already become anyways. It is not the case, I'll say this again if maybe you didn't hear before, that now the university essay is dead. It has been dead for decades, and it's been killed by professors, by administrators, and by students, all of them going along with the system as it was. Because when you have to mark hundreds or literally thousands of essays, you turn into a machine anyways. And if you dare to be a little bit different as a student, you will fail. So you become machine-like in your writing anyways. And if you dare as a professor or a TA to mark in a way that's a little bit different, that strays a little bit from the marking criteria, you are already also a disturbance to the machine, and you will also be crowded out by the machine that is higher education. So, in some very weird sense, and I think a very significant one that we have to think about more, AI will probably push us back to a lot more, less mechanistic, machinic ways of doing things and interacting with each other. I'm doing this at my academy. I'm there in the, it's an online academy, yes, but we're sitting there on online group meetings and discuss things together. And I have my students submit essays not to get marks or grades and not to get a degree, but in order to learn and understand and see and be able to write. There's nothing machinic about that. And in fact, it is precisely also we will be, I think this will really push us to a completely different understanding of technology and a different understanding of the machine, because we think of the machine as the computer is taking over. It's this massive super data center that will, you know, take on the world. It's the robots. The machine is us. We have become machinic, and we became machinic hundreds of years ago already, when we started to interpret and understand ourselves in those terms that have led to what is now mass education. So we can actually, now I'm not saying that technology is liberating us, that's nonsense. No, but it's pushing this insane logic of the machine to its utmost, to its logical conclusion. Where I often thought when I was marking essays that this should be done by a machine, and the essay should have been written by a machine also. I mean, honestly, this is what it will come down to. You will be paying £30,000 a year in the UK, maybe £100,000 a year in the US, and those who can afford the best AI will probably do the best. And that'll be the logical conclusion of higher education that has turned into serving the masses and trying to make everything accessible to everyone as long as you pay. So it's a remarkable time that we live in, and I think one shouldn't be too worried about AI, because it's pushing us precisely towards becoming more aware again of what it means to be human. But that exactly, that is the work. And so you see, the weird response by the university is to say, oh my God, we're out of a job. It's purely about, oh, we're dead. Why do you think that is? Because you already know that you are dead already, right? Instead, what the response should be from universities, and they don't give you that response, they don't even try to articulate it. It should be that one. It should be, how can we instill in young human minds humanitas, humanity? What does it mean to be human? We have incredible sources to try and respond to this question. But no, instead they just give up. And they don't give up yet, they have given up already. That's why you get to these remarks and these freakouts by professors, because it disturbs the machinic operations. You see, it's a disturbance to the benignness, the complete sort of this indifference towards what's at stake. What's at stake in university is to try and help young minds to develop so that they become human, and not to get a degree to be fit for the labor market, blah, 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 blah. If that's what you think a university is, then yes, everything should be written by AI, because there's actually no difference. Okay, signing off.